Hello, my name is Robbie Olson, and I'm a Presbyterian pastor here in Watsonville. My colleagues and I have come together today representing a wide swath of the faith community in our region because we share a deep concern for those who are suffering. In the last month, we have seen an outbreak of COVID-19 in our city at the Watsonville Post-Acute Center. Tragically, 13 people have died as a result of their infection, and 71 other patients and staff were or are still infected. We invite you to join us in this vigil to offer prayer and words of comfort from our various faith traditions, embracing our common love for neighbor and compassion for the suffering.
Los saludo con la paz de Cristo. Mi nombre es Pastor Jerry Saldaña. Soy el pastor de la Iglesia Descubrimiento aquí en Watsonville, de parte de mi esposa Marta y la congregación. Los saludamos una vez más con la paz de Cristo. Estamos aquí reunidos en este día con líderes espirituales del pueblo, aquí en un pequeño vigilia, orando por la comunidad de Watsonville y todos alrededor. Sabemos que en estos tiempos que son muy difíciles, sabemos que algunas personas han fallecido por medio del COVID. Estamos aquí para decirles que están en nuestros corazones, están en nuestras mentes y estamos orando por ustedes.
I am Reverend Robin Matthews Johnson, the pastor at Watsonville First United Methodist Church. The sorrow and joy of life weave a tapestry of our individual lives as death and illness gather us here today into a blessed community. To honor all the residents and staff from the Watsonville Post-Acute Center who are ill or who have died from COVID-19, including our beloved Millie Von Schell.
My name is Bobby Marchesault, and my heart and the collective heart of Missio Dei community with whom I minister goes out to all those who have lost loved ones in this challenging time of pandemic and of accumulating loss. We send our prayers and positive healing energy and love to all those still suffering from COVID at the Watsonville Post-Acute Center. And we express gratitude for the gift of dedicated and quality professionals who are providing health care in that space at this moment.
God, who is filled with compassion, we know that you hold for us the numbers of souls who have returned to you, the dead, from the COVID pandemic. As the ones have become tens, hundreds, and thousands, each one a loss, each soul a loved one, we ask that you bring comfort to the mourners, to all who were not able to be present as dear ones were buried, all who could not offer hugs of comfort and love.
Hi, my name is Bill Wurtenberg. I'm the minister assistant at the Watsonville Buddhist Temple. And on behalf of the Watsonville Buddhist Temple, I wish to extend our condolence and deepest sympathies to all those who have been affected by the COVID virus.
On behalf of the Santa Cruz and Watsonville Islamic community, I'd like to extend our heartfelt condolences and solidarity with those who are suffering through the loss of close ones due to the COVID-19. Though we all come from different faiths and backgrounds, we are all of the same human family, sharing the same divine breath. The loss of even one soul is a loss to all of us.
Hola, yo soy la pastora Susan Berkelo de la Iglesia Lutheran de la Comunidad en Watsonville. Y quiero decir que nuestras oraciones están con todos los que están sufriendo los efectos de este virus de COVID que tanto nos ha impactado la vida en todo sentido.
At this time, we are united with the wisdom and customs of all people of all ages. Though we are of different religions, we all feel the embrace of the ageless human community. Together, our strength and our resources are great, for they come from the deep well of all humanity, blessed by God Almighty. Today, we join our individual feelings and thoughts, as well as the different faiths that sustain us, into a harmony of remembrance and affirmation.
If you are comfortable, please join me in a prayer. Spirit of the living God, we come before you as one human family, deeply concerned for our sick and suffering neighbors. We pray that they might know your divine presence and healing touch. May the doctors, nurses, and staff who care for the sick be skillful in their care and may they remain safe and uninfected. And for all in our community, we ask for your grace that your peace that passes understanding may be upon us. Amen.
God, who is filled with healing, care for the brokenhearted among us, all those who are not able to be with loved ones who died alone, to hold their hands, bring healing to our hearts. Help us remember how to care for each other. Help us remember that we are one people. Bring us soon a completed and lasting healing, one by one, until suffering ceases. And we say, Amén.
Ustedes sabemos que no es fácil, pero yo les quiero dar una palabra de consuelo. Y si hay una palabra de consuelo hoy, leemos en el libro de Cantares, en el capítulo 8, versículo 6, que dice que porque fuerte es como la muerte el amor. Y si hay una palabra de consuelo, para mí eso habla grandemente. Sabemos que la muerte sí nos separa. Sabemos que la distancia en esa separación está tremendo y difícil y duele. Pero mira lo que dice la Escritura. La palabra de Dios dice que el amor es igual fuerte como la muerte. Eso quiere decir que en ese tiempo, cuando usted está pensando de su amado o su amada que ha fallecido por medio de este COVID, usted, por medio del amor, está pensando en ellos. Por emoción, por actividades, por eventos, lo que sea, el amor siempre está contigo.
We surround all men and women and all forms of life with infinite love and compassion. Particularly, we do send forth loving thoughts to those in suffering and sorrow, and to all those in doubt and ignorance, to all who are striving to attain truth, and to those whose feet are standing close to the great change we call death. We send forth oceans of wisdom and mercy and love. In Gosho, Namo Amida Butsu.
As Muslims, we believe in life after death. The Quran teaches us, as it was, he who inherited your being in the beginning, so also to God will you be restored. I conclude with another passage from the Quran, which is frequently recited after a passing of a loved one. But you, soul at peace, return to your Lord well-pleased and well-pleasing. Go among my servants and into my garden. Assalamu alaikum.
Today we must grieve, but we must also celebrate life. Though our grief is strong and we must mourn, we will not let the shadow of death obscure the living people, both known and unknown, who touched us and others many times in many ways, filling our lives with memories, meaning, and love. Let us be wise enough and let us be brave enough this afternoon to honestly remember and bravely celebrate all those from the post-acute center.
Nuestra fe no quita el sufrimiento y el dolor, ni borra el dolor y las lágrimas por la pérdida de un precioso ser humano. Pero nuestra fe sí es una promesa de Dios, que Dios camina con nosotros por el valle de la sombra de la muerte y llora con nosotros allí y nos guarda en sus manos en todo momento, prometiendo reunirnos. Encontramos consuelo, esperanza y fortaleza al saber quiénes somos y a quién pertenecemos. Y sabemos que tanto si vivimos como si morimos, pertenecemos al Dios que nos creó y que nos dio la vida. La muerte no tiene la última palabra.
I want to offer this moment of silent prayer before God. So in a moment, I just want to invite you to take some deep breaths and be reminded of divine presence with us, within us, and around us that connects all of us through time and through this virtual space. And so I invite you now into a silent moment of reflection, of prayer, of listening, and of simply being. Will you join me? May the peace of God that surpasses all understanding bring healing and wholeness to our hearts. In solidarity with all beloved community, amen.
Thank you for joining us in this time of unity, empathy, and compassion. I would also like to thank my colleagues for coming together as people of faith, committed to the good of our community. To our friends, family, and neighbors who are suffering from COVID-19, we will continue to pray for you and do what we can to protect you. To our wider community, we ask that you wear a mask covering both your mouth and your nose. Practice social distancing. Avoid large gatherings, and in doing so, you will live out the commandment common to our faith traditions. Love your neighbor. You'll find access to services and support resources on the screen and below in the description. And now, we offer a final prayer. Faithful healer of the sick, in your loving mercy, embrace our neighbors in their time of need. Guide the nurses, doctors, and staff, and others who attend the sick. Use their skills to restore health and joy, that all might be well and ready for service. Amen. Go in peace.